Hello everyone, and welcome. And this will be a general weekly reading for the sign of Aries for the week of March 28th through April 3rd, 2023. I would also like to give a very special thank you to all of you who have subscribed to my channel, as well as given it a thumbs up. Thank you very much for doing that. It is greatly appreciated. Coming up with some new ideas this week. Seven of Cups, dreaming of a lot of things that you want to get done and leaving some things that are not quite turning out behind you with the Eight of Cups. A lot of effort put in before you are surrendering to even the thought of perhaps walking away from this endeavor. And the Eight of Swords, so you've held back for a while on this. It's not a quick, easy decision for you. You're feeling like it almost makes you stay stuck in some ways in the Empress. But it will pan out in your favor. You know, it will be more abundant coming forward. You know, there's lots of good ambitions going on in your life. And the Lovers. Wow, there you are. You're definitely making a commitment of some sort this week to a new career, a position that, you know, speaks to your heart, something that really comes in for you. And this could be a person as well. And the Five of Swords. So, yeah, you're definitely doing a lot of contemplating on where you're at in your life, your status, what you want to have in the future, who you want to move forward with in the future, that sort of thing. You know, you've looks like you've got a lot of things going on. Maybe some people that you've trusted in the back, you know, in the past have let you down quite significantly, and now you're starting to realize it. You know, maybe people's been making fun of you, that sort of thing, and you've gotten wind of it. And the Two of Pentacles. So you've been balancing this act for a while before you're trying to make any decision here this week in all aspects of your life. Yeah, trying to lay burdens down so you don't have to do so much going forward. Maybe in your job, they just kept asking you for more and more and more. You know, expecting that you should do more all the time because that's what you do naturally. So now they've just left it all up to you that, you know, this is your responsibility. But this is the week that you're telling them, no, this is not my responsibility. And giving it back to the people that own it. Lovely. And the Ten of Cups. So there it is. Happy home, happy life, good commitments, people around you or people that you want in your life, friends, family, co-workers, that sort of thing. You know, you're feeling more emotionally secure once you take care of this part of your life. And if this is a new relationship that you're entering into, this could be one that lasts for a significant amount of time, which is nice. And the King of Swords. All right. So you're definitely flooded with all kinds of ideas this week in your love life, in your career, in your family life. You know, if there's problems going on or you feel there's a problem going on, you're going to remedy that. You know, you're going to head the problem straight on. You're going to try to find a solution. And there you are, something on offer, you know, some sort of message coming in for you. Maybe it's an unexpected call that you receive from somebody you haven't heard from for a long time. You know, somebody tracking you down, that sort of thing. And the Three of Swords, it could be somebody that you were involved with in the past and, you know, they're trying to talked a way back around sort of thing, but you're having none of it because, you know, the damage was done a while back and other than saying your peace and your that, you're just going to let it go. And the moon card. So there you are. You know, all of a sudden, everything in your life has taken a new perspective this week. You know, your mood swings are starting to change. You're starting to realize that, you know, you count more than the rest of the world, sort of thing. And you're starting to realize that you need to take care of your own self. You know, you need to get more sleep. You know, you're getting a little, maybe some of you is a little more exercise. You know, you're following your intuitions here because you know that it's spot on. Like, you're not worried about it. It's just coming naturally to you. You're more sharp in your thinking this week. Like, your people are talking to you and you're picking up on the clues quite quickly, so nobody can, you know, think they're clever and try to slide things by you. But you definitely have some genuine ideas that you want to, you know, get finished with. So you're trying to figure out what to tackle first this week, you know, which way you want to go, who you want to deal with, so that you can, you know, just clear the air and your conscience and their conscience, and you can just move forward. So, you know, because you want more better people that are in your life, people that are on your side, people that understand you, and you can feel comfortable within yourself. You know, you don't have to worry about what you said might have, you know, offended somebody, or you're, you know, upsetting them. You can just literally, you know, let your hair down, have good times with good friends. So you have a lot of, you know, general feelings for a lot of people, and now you're starting to see who has the same for you and who doesn't. And that's okay too, because that's how you open up to better things in your life, by realizing what you need to let go of and who you need to let go of. For some of you, this could actually be a new addition in the family as well. Maybe a new fur baby or a child, you know, or this new project that you're trying to get off the ground, that you're going to just, you know, hunker down and get with it, sort of thing, so that it can, you know, instead of being the little coin at the bottom, it's starting to grow and multiply for you. And you want it to, so you're putting a little more effort in, and that's why you're letting other people deal with their own stuff. Here you're just telling them, you know, I haven't got the time nor the patience, nor should I have. You know, this isn't my burden to carry, and you're giving it back. You're tired of always worried about if you say the right thing or do the right thing, you know, that one of those pentacles may drop on you there. So you're just letting people handle their own stuff this week, because you've got enough on your own plate and you want to get this new endeavor off the ground. So you're putting people to the side for a change for yourself. You're taking a well-deserved time for yourself, you know, so that you can get, you know, all your stuff in a row. You don't have to worry about anything anymore. You know what you want to have in the end, in the finish line. So you know what you have to clear out to make it happen, and you're willing to do that this week. And I think with you doing that, will also open you up to releasing the past, you know, your hurts in your life, the ones that left some profound marks on you, so that it can open you up to, you know, new love in the future. But I think this is more, you know, you're having a more passionate time with yourself, like a talk about what your expectations are for who you want to come into your future. And you realize that you need to shut the door on a few things and let things go, so that you can be more open to receiving. And that's what your goal is for yourself this week. So good for you. You're moving in a more positive direction for yourself. Pardon me. All right, I'm going to shuffle and deal you an angel oracle card. But your cards are very positive this week. You have the ambition and the attitude that I'm going to make this happen and I'm going to buckle down and do what I got to do to make sure that it comes around to the way that I envision it. So good on you again. That's a very hard thing to do sometimes, isn't it? All right. You are protected from all types of harm. The worst is now behind you. I ask you to relax and feel safe. Well, that's a beautiful card for you. All right. And on that note, I will say goodbye for now, and I will talk to you again soon. Until then, stay safe, stay healthy, and bye for now.